this way when you've been in the staff as well. Okay. Everybody is on by. It's on the front. That's where you'll stay. Well, that's the front. You might zoom in a bit on the speaker, especially when you're about to play stage from the back. Stage. Zoom in. I'll see what you're doing. I'll give it this or this to you. Fast, so you can know this one. Okay.
everyone. If you could please stand as the graduates process in. Thank you. Thank you.
We ask your blessing on the graduating class of 2018 as they prepare to move on to new beginnings in their lives. Love you, God. Guide these graduates on the journey that lay ahead of them as they prepare to encounter new and exciting opportunities. May they recognize the contributions they have made to this community. Help them recognize their gifts as they make decisions about their future. May they be guided and supported on the journey by their family, friends, teachers, and staff in this community. Bless them with a healthy, happy, and rewarding future in which they clearly see their ability and never cease to follow their dreams. We ask this in your holy name. Amen. In the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thanks very much, Mr. McGregor. Can you hear us at the back okay? No? Mr. Horan, can you hear us okay in the back okay? A couple of housekeeping items before we begin. There are extra programs available after if you wanted to get some or souvenir. Bathrooms, you'll notice right outside the gym here, there's a sign on them. We're having some difficulty with them today. So the bathroom, if you need to go, is out that door and around back here. So please don't go through this door, but rather exit that way and go around if you have to go to the bathroom. Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, dignitaries, parents, family, and of course, graduates. My name is Cole Kramer, and this evening with Mr. Andrew Burke, we will be your Masters of Ceremony. Now, I would like to begin this ceremony this evening talking about some messages that you may hear tonight, and some messages in the speeches that you may not hear tonight. To make sure that you fully understand me, because music is a universal language, Mr. Burke will act as my musical interpreter. He is, of course, a man of many talents, as you know. So we'll get started. Now, I'll put my glasses on. Grade 12, because you're not quite grad yet, you're almost there. Think back to when you first walked through the doors at Holy Trinity. You were probably pretty nervous, not knowing what to expect of high school.
Hey, I'm all shook up.
Then over the last 4 or 5 years, you found your groove. Some of you found sports, some found the arts, others found clubs, such as the travel club, or you got into sciences or math, or French, or even tech class.
A Greek standing. Greek standing.
And now you are graduating high school.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Tonight, you may hear many messages about setting goals and following your dreams.
Somewhere over the rainbow.
But here are some messages that you might not hear. Life is not a Disney movie. There will be many bumps as you travel down the road.
Let it go.
Get ready to pay some bills. Go out and find yourself a job, or maybe two.
I hope.
Now, your bosses aren't going to accept a no for myself to probably mispronounce your name later in the evening.
Is it too late now to say sorry?
And of course, this is really your last evening in high school, so on behalf of Mr. Burke and myself and our staff, congratulations, graduates.
Na, 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 na.
Accepting of others and seeing these rivers. Be patient. Be kind. been a teacher for 14 years now, but I knew my educational philosophy long before I started teaching. It grew out of a story that I once heard in my late 20s, which began with an old man walking along a beach, something that he did every morning before he began his work. On one of those mornings, he was walking along the shore after a big storm had passed by. He found the beach littered with starfish, as far as the eye could see, stretching in both directions. Off in the distance, the old man noticed a small boy approaching. As the boy walked, he paused ever so often, and as he grew closer, the man could see that he was approaching, bending down to pick up an object and throw it into the sea. The boy came closer still, and the man called out, "Good morning! May I ask what it is that you are doing?" The young boy paused, looked up, and replied, "Throwing starfish into the ocean. The tide has washed them up onto the beach, and they can't return to the sea by themselves. When the sun is high, they will die, unless I throw them back into the water." The old man replied, "But there must be tens of thousands of starfish on this beach. I'm afraid you won't really be able to make much of a difference." The boy bent down, picked up yet another starfish, and threw it as far as he could into the ocean. Then he turned, smiled, and said, "Made a difference in apple." St. Mother Teresa of Calcutta said, "Not all of us can do great things, but we can do small things with great love. A single ordinary person can still make a difference, and single ordinary people are doing precisely that every day. You don't have to do something extraordinary to lead a meaningful life. You don't have to cure cancer, become an Instagram celebrity, or write the next best-selling novel. Freud said that the meaning of life lies in love and work. So, in your relationships, lead with love. Be generous. Be vulnerable. Give of yourself to others. Make the effort to put people first. In your career, find work that makes you proud and adopt a service mindset. Try to remember how what you're doing helps others. No matter how big or small the impact might be. Touching the life of just one single person is a powerful legacy to leave behind. Experience has taught me that if you love life, then life will love you back. Graduates, you are the future. You are our future. And the future is bright. Congratulations, class of 2018.
Over the past 4 years, you have had guidance of the teachers and other school staff to building a bright future. The people who are important in your life, your family, friends, teachers, and support staff, have provided you with the foundation you need to learn and grow. And they have been a nurturing presence in your life. They have helped foster your unique strengths to prepare you for the path after high school. Please don't forget to say thank you to those who have helped you get here today. We do not make it in life alone. We need to rely on others for some help, guidance, and encouragement. We also thank you for the many ways you have shared your special gifts and skills in your Catholic school community. Your contributions have blessed and challenged us, and we have become richer, more inclusive, and a more diverse community because of you. Whatever path you choose next, whether it is entering the workforce, gaining an apprenticeship, or going to college or university, it is our sincere hope that you will continue to explore your passion and find your path to a successful future. We hope you will go out into the world as responsible and caring citizens, committed to transforming the world in your own way. I know you will rise to whatever challenge that awaits you. I wish you all the best for a bright and successful future. Again, I want to congratulate the class of 2018.
I would like to close by reminding you of our vision at Simple Scope.
So once again, I'd like to extend congratulations to all the graduates. Thank them for working so hard to get here. Best wishes and successful future. God bless.
Last 10 years,
places to eat out and things to do right here in our community than there were before you were born. This is a trend that's going to continue. It has been estimated that by the year 2031, more than 50,000 people will live here in PWD, and the service and amenities can be expected to grow and to meet the needs of a larger community. As your elected officials, we on Town Council have been here to try and make PWD a better place that you can live, work, and play throughout all seasons of your life. Even if you're leaving after graduation to go to school somewhere else, I hope that many of you will return to put your hard-earned skills to work right here hard now. Whether you go on to further education, or to employment, or both, I hope that the skills you have developed and the friendships you have made while student here at Holy Team will serve you well, and that you can draw on them in times of doubt. I want to stop right there and talk about an event I went to last week. I was at the National Aboriginal Day here in Bradford, one of the Green Valley Lions Church. And Paul Burston played a small video, a 2-3 minute video, and in that video, to my surprise, was this high school that has helped out the community 2,000 kilometers away that have third world living conditions there. And this graduating class and others from the school have been there to help that community. So I really appreciate it. I'm very proud of what it's been to the community to see young people like yourself doing such things like that to help that community. It's a great thing to do, and I was so proud of this high school and what the staff here have done to help out. It's been said that two of the greatest gifts we can give our children are roots and wings. May our small town feeling always be with you to ground you and give you your roots. And as you enter the chapter in your life, may you explore, grow, and take pleasure in life wherever your wings be taken. On behalf of Town Council, please accept my best wishes for your future endeavors.
Scholar John Kirby and the others.
Haley Aldry.
Ontario scholar Ashley Emery.
love for Sorry. Ontario scholar David Ness.
Amanda LaChance.
student, Sarah McGuire. Christina Maduro.
Come on. Benvenuto.
Thank you.
before I start talking about the awards, I really want to say thank you to the Bradford community. Without the Bradford community and all the support that we get from the various businesses and people of Bradford, we wouldn't be able to bestow these awards onto our graduates. The first half of the awards are academic, and the second half are not academic. What will happen is I'll name the award, I'll name the recipient's name, and while the student who has received the award comes up, I'll explain their criteria. Okay, now should do everything well along very nicely. I came up with that idea by myself. Okay, no, I did. Actually, let's do something about that. Okay. The Switzer Cardi Transportation Business Award. This year's recipient is Marcel Salvatore. It is awarded to the graduate student with the highest mark. And I'll ask Mr. Mike Hartfield to please present to Marcel.
Rob
Devin, please present to Marissa, who had high academic standing and also contributed to the course with creativity and dedication. Well done. The Royal Canadian Legion Branch 521 French Award, this year's recipient is Angelique Oliveira.
Jeremy, who had
highest academic standing and dedication and contribution to the music program and to the Holy Trinity Band. The Midas Philosophy Award. This year's recipient is Serena Delgrande.
Thank you.
This year's recipient is Alyssa Marks. I'll ask this man lady in the room who's with Alyssa, who have the highest academic achievement in this course.
This award is given to a student
who demonstrates compassion, commitment, and perseverance. Someone who sets a good example but may not necessarily be going to post-secondary education, just a really good person overall. Mr. Mike and Mrs. Carol Collier are here to present.
Yeah.
recipient, there are two, Gabriel Jensen and Rachel Clark.
Award, the Holy Martyrs of Japan Christian Witness Award, goes to these two students as well.
The Piano Music Studio Award for Music. This year's recipient is Jeremy Kurtzbach.
Award. This year's recipient is Angela.
exemplified mission statement. The Chartwell's Carl Cadero Award. Carl Cadero was the founding principal of Holy Trinity High School. If you want to blame someone for hiring Mr. Kramer, myself, it was Mr. Carl Cadero. Mr. Cadero was the founding principal of Holy Trinity High School. This award is awarded to a student who, throughout his or her high school career, has lived the model and grown through love and example. The student has demonstrated this spirit of determination, joy, caring, and selfish concern for all people and all things. This year's recipient is Lisa Connolly. Thank you.
We have organizations, such as the Thai greeting, for recycling Yumi. And the families and friendships have been created and formed on Yumi trips. Huge goes on to the Euro gang, and for many of us, remember the greatest tour guide, Tom. Ultimately, the 4 years of high school have definitely taught us lessons. Lessons about finding out who we truly are, what we are capable of doing, the rights and wrongs, and perhaps considering who your true friends are and aren't. And most importantly, the power of memory, which I think the multi seems to lack because we still haven't gotten our grade 10 assignments by.
Many titles and victories. And to all the clubs and organizations that have been given to us,
It'll be very hard to part ways with different parts of the province, the country, and possibly the world. It'll be different living on our own, not being able to wake up to see your shorty or your tig every day, not being able to see your squad every day, or never having the chance to encounter the big, bald, foolish man in the halls every day. Graduates, never forget where you come from. Share the values and lessons you learned here with the people you meet out there. Be a light to this world. Work with others by building bridges and not walls. Whatever God's plan is for us, wherever He may lead us, let us never forget those who invested countless hours for the good of our future, with their unending love and support. I give a huge thanks to my parents, Arvin and Marvin, who stood by my side throughout these 4 years and allowed me to push for my goals and dreams. On behalf of the class of 2018, I'd like to give a huge thank you and appreciation to all the parents, staff, and teachers for having the patience for our troubled students during these past 4 years and enlightening us with their knowledge in all different areas of expertise. Thank you for narrowing our path of study down the science path, arts, humanities, math, history, and so on. I would also like to give a huge thanks to all my friends. I'd like to call my family for reminding me life is too short to not have fun. Especially to all my gym bros, who inspire and push me to get through every repetition set.
Yay!
And of course, all my YouTube followers, all 30 of you. Let us never forget all the friendships and relationships starting here and ending here. In the class.
Thank you.
completion of this ceremony, I would ask all of you to come and join us in the small gym just through those doors. We have a reception there for you to enjoy. Ask the graduates to please stand.